Hello everyone, myself Preeti Gajjar, lecturer in computer department from VPMP Polytechnic. Today's my subject is Advanced Database Management System and the unit is Normalization. Topic name is Basics of Normalization. After watching this video, you will be able to learn about basics of normalization, advantages of normalization, disadvantages of normalization, goal of normalization, how many list of normal forms are there, and we will learn in detail about the first normal form in this video. Basics of normalization. First of all, we see the definition or what is normalization. Normalization is the iterative process which proceeds in top-down fashion by applying criteria of normal forms and decomposing relations if required. That means normalization, it is one kind of a process, and this process is iterative process which perform in repetition manner, right? Which proceeds in a top-down fashion. So in our programming and in database, we design such things in top-down or bottom to up in this scenario. So here in this normalization process, the process is proceeds in a top to bottom direction, and by applying criteria of normal forms, each of the normal forms having their own rules. So to go ahead with the normal forms, you have to apply your different criteria, or we can say rules, and if necessary, then you have to decompose the relations. So this is the normalization. Again, it is a iterative process, proceeds in a top-down fashion by applying criteria of normal forms and decomposing the relations if required. Types of normal forms according to diploma syllabus available are first normal form, second normal form, and third normal form. Other normal forms are BCNF, 4NF, and 5NF, which is not included in the syllabus of diploma. Here, the second normal form is better than 1NF, 3NF is better than 2NF in such a way. So which of the normal forms is applicable to your database is depending on your database and how you are applying the criteria and the rules of the normalization. For most business database design purpose, 3NF is as high as we need to go in normalization process. So if you achieve the third normal form criteria in your database, then it is more than enough for your business purpose. Highest level of normalization is not always most desirable. So it is not required that always in your database you get the fifth normal form, right? Up to second, third, it is a better thing. So this is the general we can say points discuss about what is normalization and types of normalization. Now, advantages of normalization. It is used to avoid data modifications, like we can say insert, delete, update, anomalies. In database, whenever there is a problem of insert, update, delete operations, it is known as a modification anomalies. So when you apply the normalization, it reduces the reduces the anomalies of these insert, update, and delete operations. Greater flexibility in getting the expected data in atomic granular. It is clearer and easier technique to manage your change. A better handle on database security also. Increased storage efficiency. Normalization process helps maximize the use of clustered indexes. Smaller databases in that by eliminating duplicate data, you will be able to reduce the overall size of the database and better performance. So these are the advantages of, we can say, a normalization. Now the disadvantages of normalizations are, it requires more CPU memory and IO, that means input output operations to process the reduced database performance. So whenever you are applying the criteria of normal forms, it requires the most CPU memory and input output operations. So it reduces the database performance. Requires more joints to get the desired results. So whenever we are not getting the or we are not able to apply the rules of normalization, we are decomposing those relations, or we can say tables. So when you want to retrieve or fetch the data required for your operation, at that time you have to perform more join operations, and you know that join operations are a bit complex. So a poorly written query can bring the database down, and the maintenance overhead is also high in normalization process. So these are the disadvantages of, we can say, a normalization. Now the goal of normalization, why we need to apply the normalization in our database. So it minimizes the data redundancy. Redundancy means duplication. So in our database concept, whenever there are duplication of data, it creates the memory, creates the problem in the insert update operations, and also it is a wastage of, we can say, a memory. So when we apply the normalization, it reduces or it minimizes the data redundancy. And minimize update, insert, delete problems, as we discussed before few minutes, that insert, update, delete anomalies. So these are the, when we apply the normalization, it again minimizes the level of these problems, or we can say, we after applying the normalization, it reduces this kind of problems. So these are the goal of normalization. Now what is normal forms? So as a definition, we can say a normal form is the state of relation that results from applying criteria on that relation. And our normal form is the state of relation, or we can say table. Anytime when you are applying the rules or criteria of the normal forms, so at a particular moment or at a particular time, the state of relation, which kind of normal forms you are applying to your relation, that state is known as a normal form. So list of normal forms, as I said earlier, are first normal form. In short, we can write it like as 1NF. For second normal form, it is 2NF. Third normal form, it is 3NF. There is a variation of 3NF, and it is known as a Boyce code normal form, and the short form is BCNF. Then fourth normal form is 4NF, and fifth normal form is 5NF. First normal form, let's see the details of first normal form and the criteria, or we can say a rule of first normal form. Is a relation schema R is in 1NF if it does not have any composite attribute, multi-valued attribute, or their combination. Here there are two special words, and these are the composite attribute and multi-valued attribute. So let's understand what is this. So composite attribute means the attributes which are divided again in more than one attribute, say like address. So we can divide the address in society and city and pin code number, etc. So the attribute which having again which is divided again in more than one attribute is known as composite attribute. And the multi-valued attribute means attribute which having more than one value, like contact number, a person having more than one contact numbers. So to apply the criteria of first normal form, you have to remove the composite attribute and multivalued attribute or their combination from the relation. So a relation schema R is in 1NF. Relation schema R, that means any relation is in 1NF when it does not have any composite attribute, multivalued attribute or their combination. And if it is there, then you have to remove those attributes from the relation. So composite and multivalued attribute creates problems in storing and retrieving the data. So remove it using decomposition. Decomposition is the process to divide the relation in one or more tables. So to remove the effect of composite and multivalued attributes, we have to so this is the, we can say, example of first normal form. Here the our relation is a customer, and it has attributes like customer ID, name, address is divided in a society and city over here, and the contact number. Customer ID C01 and C02, two records are there, and you have to focus on the attribute address, which is a composite attribute, and address is divided in a two more columns, and we cannot store this data in a single cell, right? And in contact number, in C01 customer, you can see that there are two contact numbers. So in a one cell, we cannot store the two contact numbers. So it is a multi-valued attribute. So here it address is composite attribute and contact number is multi-valued attribute. Now, after decomposition, as we see, our relation customer is not in a first normal form, and there is a presence of composite and multivalued attribute, and we have to remove those presence of those attributes, and for that we have to decompose that relation in such a way that we can remove the composite and multivalued effects of the attribute. So this in a solution we can write it like in customer table, we solve the problems of composite attribute, and in that address attribute we divide that address in society and city to different columns, and we are removing that address field name, and we create four columns in a customer table like customer ID, name, society and city, right? Now in this way we are removing the concept of composite attribute, and now in for multivalued attribute we are creating customer underscore contact a new relation, and it having two columns, customer ID and contact number. So by entering more than one one customer ID more than one time, and we are entering different contact numbers in different cells, we can store multiple contact numbers of one customer, right? So customer and customer underscore contact, this table customer is divided and decomposed into such relations, and maintaining the criteria of first normal form by removing the composite attribute and multivalued attributes presence, right? So here we can say that our table customer and customer underscore contact is in first normal form. Thank you.